To start, but it's good that you have made this presentation, but because sustainability, when we define sustainability, we talk about three areas of sustainability. We talk about the economical part and the ecological part and the social part. And we have to take all three into consideration. Right now, it's widely understood that sustainability is a problem that the humanity is facing as a whole, the whole society, and it's because,
do you know
it, because engineers, the ones who design things, it should be a PDF. It's track 12.
Yeah.
Track 12 should be.
You have a
pen.
Is that yours?
No, everybody need their presentation team. It's mine! Okay. So if we can ship it. So we have these three parts of sustainability. And in the previous session, I heard something that simply horrified me. And they said, the objective of our project is to arouse the interest of the children in technology. So, why do we need to make children interested in technology? I'm an engineer, and my interest shouldn't be technology. I'm an engineer because I fix problems, I solve problems. I'm not amazed at the technology. I am a technophiliac, complete technophiliac. I'm using PDAs since 95. So I've been using PDAs and these kinds of devices for 20 years. So I'm completely, I like these things. But it's a vice, it's a defect of mine. It's one flaw of my personality. And at least I understand it. It's a flaw. I like these things. I like shiny objects, silvery, with. They are technical things and they entertain my brain, so I don't go crazy and want to conquer the world and destroy the humanity. But it's my flaw. I don't want to pass on this flaw. But I have one virtue, is I'm an engineer, I'm able to fix problems. And what we have is we have a lot of generations of engineers that have been fixing problems. But the problem is how we define a problem. If we define a problem in terms of, okay, we need to be sustainable, so we're going to use things that smell green, and Greenpeace is not going to go for us. It's one way to look at it. Unfortunately, it's not the only way that that things have been looked at. Usually, the way that technology problems have been conducted is through that economical dimension. Through the economical dimension, always the economical dimension. Usually an engineer says, okay, you have to build a bridge and you have to, we have to be able to move these trucks and so many people, and we have this limitation process. But there are other two other dimensions. And one of the problems that we have is that engineers, we are becoming, because the system of the education that we carry, we are becoming so much focused in learning the technology. And we get amazed at these amazing and fascinating technical problems. But we don't say, okay, first what we have to do is think about how to define a problem. So in our paper we tell several cooperation projects. Because when I teach about sustainability in engineering, what I do is I integrate in the whole teaching. It's not something separate, so I cannot take it out to make a presentation here. But we had an experience. It was back in 2008, where I was crazy about smartphones and mobile things. I was speaking about mobile learning, it was going to be amazing. And then somebody told me, do you want to go to Africa, to a nice country called Burkina Faso? We have a university there, and they want you to go to make a lecture there. Nicolas came with me. There was when we met in the airport, precisely. Now he's making a PhD under my supervision. And then I decided not to go. As a teacher, as a professor, I decided to go on vacation. My wife went there as a professor, so I was hanging around. And I could gather some information to develop the course that I wanted to teach the next year. Because, for instance, in the there was one professor called Eduard Taiwadén of our university, and he went to world school, and he wasn't concerned about technology as much as I am. So when he talked about, he thought about education in the third world, he wasn't like Nicolas Negroponte building the 100 computer. But what he did was to go to a school and meet children like this beautiful girl. And then they developed this technology, educational technology. This is a technological solution to a problem. It's not about tablets, because in this school, these are tablets. Mm-hmm. When tablets, it's not Android, it's not iPads, these, when tablets are things like this, and the classrooms are really in cramped buildings, so hot that you cannot stand more than 1 hour because children would get ill, what they said, okay, what we need to do is, the classes should look like this. When you are in 40 degrees Celsius, you could try some algae there. let's try the algae by bringing it to Burkina Faso, you put it in the shade, it will become dry, but in a few hours. And it's okay, children are sitting on the ground under a baobab tree, and so they said, okay, let's build these banks where the children can see it, and we're going to build it. And they say, okay, if we have to build it, how are we going to build it? Say, let's make it of concrete, because it's something that will not break down, it's something that will not be affected by the elements, it's something that nobody will steal. Mm-hmm. And during the conduction of the project, they had to hire some watchmen to watch over the cement and the tools, so nobody would steal it while it was built. And now they have in this school, this is Eduard, that's my wife, and they have this classroom which is outside of the classroom, and they have painted a blackboard behind the blackboard. And for me this was amazing, because I saw that this was an engineering project in something that so simple, like putting concrete blocks outside of the school. Because it fixes the problem, and in a way that is sustainable, and understand what's going on there. Another group of scientists missionaries or people that go to Africa would have gone with tablets or something like that. And then when I saw this example, I thought, okay, so what should be the course that I'm going to give, the lectures that I'm going to give next year when I come back, because the country is so beautiful and you can eat very well and they are so kind, and it's a drive to Madrid, you can die of diarrhea or something like that, which happens, of course, sometimes. What I have to say is, these are students in Burkina Faso studying computer science engineering. These guys are learning about software development, and if I have to teach something, I have to teach software development, because it's my main skill. I develop software. I look at the computers, and in the classrooms, and in the computer lab there was like one finger of sand inside the lab, because some windows were broken, and the school was right in the middle of the savannah.
And we knew that the hard drives of the computers were stolen that winter. We brought in 2007, my university brought some computers with hard drives. Computers and hard drives were stolen. So if I have to make a software, for instance, the management of a small business in a fashion, and the life expectancy because of the quality of electricity, because technology is going to be stolen, because of viruses. When one student connected one USB drive to your computer, you get automatically like 20 or 40 viruses all together at the same time. You have to remove all your files so that the viruses could come inside the computer. So I have to think, what am I going to teach this? I say, okay, maybe the solution is to teach them cloud computing, to develop in the cloud. Because I would then say, okay, I cannot teach them to work with one computer and make software that will stay in the computer. I have to. These guys are going to have a chance doing software if they can make. If they can either sell software outside of Burkina Faso, where there's a lot of more cash to go around, and they will not be able to know for sure that their computer is going to be there tomorrow, because it's going to be stolen, or it's going to be broken, or it's going to break down because of bad quality of the energy. So, if we as teachers of technology have to teach something, is don't think about the technology that you have. It's try to analyze the problem and ask, talk to the people that are there. We have some more pictures here of the school. These are the students in my classroom, great guys. And that's it. That's my whole point. And I would like you to simply analyze every presentation in this whole conference under this light. What is the problem that we are fixing, and what dimensions are we missing in our definition of the problem, because are the problems that we will need to fix in 20 years or in 5 years.